Hi everyone, it's Alex from Seabreeze. Hope you're keeping well. I've got a great, easy midweek fish recipe for you today. We're gonna do a pan roasted king clip with a soy, fish sauce, sesame oil, and ginger marinade. And then we're gonna cook some turmeric rice for it to go with, and some baby corn that's gonna be delicious and crunchy to go with the fish. So we sourced everything locally. We've got green listed king clip that we source locally here in Cape Town, and you can buy at Seabreeze every day. We've got some ginger. I'm gonna show you a nice little tip and trick to peel the ginger. Some spring onion and coriander for garnish and flavor. Some baby corn. Plain basmati rice that I'm gonna jazz up with some turmeric. And then the marinade for the king clip. Very simple, store cupboards, soy sauce, sesame oil, and fish sauce. So also in the marinade, just a touch of sugar as well, just a teaspoon of normal white sugar. Okay, so I'm gonna start with making the marinade for the king clip. I wanna give that about 10-15 minutes in the marinade. While that's marinating, I'm gonna prepare the ginger and cook the rice off. Great, so now I'm gonna start with the marinade. So, got a cup measure, I've got a third cup, so that's about 80 ml. The biggest thing going in is the soy sauce. So, third of a cup, about 80 ml of soy. This is dark soy. If you haven't got dark soy, it's fine to use light soy. Now I'm gonna put in a teaspoon of white sugar. Now I've got sesame oil. This, I'm gonna put in about half of a third of a cup. So in real terms, that's about 40 ml of sesame oil. It's gonna give a lovely flavor. In that goes. And then last, but by no means least, fish sauce. Now, I'm not gonna season the fish because I've got fish sauce going in. Fish sauce, soy sauce are all great salt replacements. So if you don't like adding lots of salt to things, then fish sauce and soy sauce are your friend. And again, I've got about half of the third cup, so about 40 ml of fish sauce has gone in there. So I'm just gonna whisk that together to dissolve the sugar. Now the great thing about Asian cooking is all about balance. So you wanna balance sweet, savory, umami, and sourness. So you've got all of these flavors are gonna come through with this. So just dissolve the sugar in there and we're good to go. So all I'm gonna do now is pour the marinade on the king clip, and then I'm gonna leave that to marinate for about 10 minutes whilst we prep up the ginger and get the rice cooking. Great, so now I'm gonna show you how to julienne the ginger, and then what I'm gonna do with the julienne ginger. Julienne means cutting it into very fine strips. We're gonna fry that off in some olive oil, and that's the oil we're then gonna cook the fish in. So you've got this amazing ginger infused olive oil, and we're gonna keep the ginger for later on, and we're gonna use that for garnish for the king clip. So here's a tip for ginger. So I've got about 100 grams of ginger there. I'm not gonna use all of it, I wanna use about 50 grams. So I'm just gonna cut that in half. I've got the nice straight stem here. Now don't use a peeler, use a teaspoon. And you just take your teaspoon and you see how easy that is to peel the hard skin off of the ginger. And it leaves less wastage as well. So you're getting as much of the ginger to use as possible. It's really handy if you've got little nubbles or whatever you want to call them, little ginger roots. It just works its way around them. See how nice and easy the skin comes off the ginger. We're really lucky here in the Western Cape. We do get really good fresh ginger from time to time. I normally keep an eye on Oranjezicht Farmers Market, and whenever they've got some fresh ginger, I go down and get some from there, because that stuff that you can just grate straight away. It's not woody, it's not been dried out at all. So, to julienne the ginger, and do start cutting it into thin strips. Just using your fingers to hold the ginger in place. Just nice fine strips. Get one more there. And then when you've got it, lay it flat. And again, nice fine strips like that. Okay, so we've got all of our prep done now. Now it's time to start cooking. So I'm gonna start off by cooking off the ginger in the olive oil. So I've got about a third of a cup of olive oil in there, just on a nice medium heat, don't want it too hot. So we're gonna kick off, ginger goes in, nice sizzle, and this is gonna make an amazing flavor in the oil that we're gonna cook the king clip in. What we're gonna do is we're gonna cook this until it starts browning, and then we're gonna take it out and reserve it for when we have finished the dish. Smell is fantastic. And then over here, I've got some rice on the go. So I've got some basmati. Very, very simple. 1 cup of rice, 2 cups of water. Medium heat. I'm gonna season the rice with plenty of salt. And then I'm gonna give it a little shake of turmeric. So it's a little shake. Goes in there. And what that'll do is give us gorgeous yellow rice. Okay, so we can just leave that to simmer along. Keep an eye on it though. We don't want it overcooking. So, ginger's browning up. Getting that flavour into the oil. I'm cooking, so we're getting this nice and brown. So I'm just going to take the ginger out of the pan now. Pop it on some kitchen towel. Now we've got an amazing ginger infused oil to cook our king clip in. Okay, so the king clip can go in now. We're keeping that marinade, we're gonna use that to make the sauce. And we're going what would be skin side down first. That sizzle. These are quite thick fillets, so I reckon we're going to take about 10 minutes to cook them, which will be perfect timing to get the rice cooked. And we're going to let that king clip cook off. We're not going to mess about with it. We're just going to leave it in the pan, let it do its thing. We're going to watch it. It will start turning pearlescent from the bottom up, where the skin was. That's going to help protect it. And then we're going to turn it over towards the end, cook off the last third, and we're going to cook off the corn, and we're going to finish the dish. Right, so king clip's just about cooked. Turned it over, giving it a couple of minutes on the other side. How do I know it's cooked? The flakes are starting to come apart. I'm going to put the tip of the knife through. It's nice and soft. Firm. So I'm just going to put the corn in now. I've just split the baby corn, and that's just going to heat through. Once that's done, I'm going to take everything out, and then I'm going to put the marinade that we reserved from earlier. That's going to go back in the pan, and that's going to make an amazing sauce. We're just going to reduce that. Let's pop this in. Pop that one out of the way. Okay. Now, king clip's a lovely fish to do Asian dishes with because it takes flavour so well. It takes the flavour of soy, it takes the flavour of ginger, it takes the flavour of sesame, and really absorbs and makes the fish taste of those flavours. It's quite neutral in flavour, king clip. That's why it's perfect for this kind of dish. You could use hake, but I find with a flakier fish like that, it does have a tendency to break apart when you're cooking it. You want something nice and whole like this. So we're just giving that sweet corn, that baby corn, a minute, and I'm gonna take that out now. I'll start by taking the king clip out. Got two lovely pieces. Giving that corn just the heat through. Just starting to wilt a touch now, so that's perfect to come out. Okay, now our marinade's gonna go in. I'll just turn the heat down on the pan a touch because I don't want any of the marinade to spit. Okay, now that's in, I can turn the heat back up and I'm just gonna reduce that by half just to make it a nice syrupy marinade, syrupy sauce now, and that's just gonna be full of flavor to finish the dish off. So while that's reducing, my rice is ready. So let's get the rice over. It's got a lovely turmeric rice, nice and fluffy grains, and that's gonna be absolutely delicious. The marinade is reducing down. Let's get the rice on the plate. Now, I know some people are not fans of coriander. You don't have to put the coriander in if you don't like it. If you think it tastes like soap and it's the devil's herb, then don't put it in. Look at that lovely sticky marinade. It's gonna be a lovely sticky sauce. So I'm just gonna take corn. Plate that neatly. I'm gonna take our fish. Just pop that nicely on top of the rice. And now I've got all my garnishes. So I'm gonna start with crispy ginger. Crispy ginger. I've just shredded that spring onion and that's gonna go on top as well. For the one of us that likes coriander, gets coriander. Our sauce is reduced by about half now, so we've got this lovely sticky marinade-y glaze sauce that's going to go on top. I'm just going to let that cool a touch before I pour it on. I'm just going to pour on just a little bit of the sauce like that. And on the other dish, there we go. Great, so here we have it. King clip, turmeric rice, corn, ginger oil, lovely marinade. This was ready in about 15 minutes cooking time and about 10 minutes marinating time. Don't forget you can get all the fish from Seabreeze, come and see us at the deli. We're also selling wine now there as well. We've got amazing olive oil from Oakhurst, we've got olives, we've got tapenade, I'm making curry sauce. Give us a bell, check us on Facebook, and you can see what we're gonna have the next day. So come down and see us, 213 Bree Street. We're there Monday to Saturday. So enjoy your fish. Fish doesn't have to be frightening. Fish is delicious.